For months, we have not been able to live normal lives because of the virus. And now it's even worse. Washington, D.C. looks like a war zone right now because of a different virus. This virus is the big lie. The big lie that the election was stolen, spread by President Trump and his allies. And there's already an attempt by those who willingly spread this virus to avoid any accountability, to rewrite history. Here's House Republican leader Kevin McCarthy this week.
What we saw last week was not the American way. Neither is the continued rhetoric that Joe Biden is not the legitimate president. Let's be clear. Joe Biden will be sworn in as president of the United States in 1 week because he won the election.
Unbelievable. Zero acknowledgement that McCarthy himself, for 2 months, pushed that very same big lie rhetoric.
President Trump won this election, so everyone who's listening, do not be quiet. Do not be silent about this. We cannot allow this to happen before our very eyes.
McCarthy, House Minority Whip Steve Scalise, and 124 other House Republicans went so far as to sign on to that joke of a lawsuit from the Texas Attorney General, which lent further credibility to the big lie. And where do people like that go to share the big lie? MAGA media.
Get it right. They stole it.
All right.
We need to take it back for the people.
MAGA media, where hosts not only didn't push back on the big lie, they also participated in it.
I can factually tell you tonight, it will be impossible to ever know the true, fair, accurate election results.
We don't know exactly what the Supreme Court will do, but there is precedent for courts overturning the results of elections.
It was a joint effort by the Trump team and MAGA media, and millions heard lies about election fraud day after day.
This happened in the places where it needed to happen, which is why the four metros, the only four where Joe Biden outperformed Hillary Clinton, were Philadelphia, Milwaukee, Atlanta, and Detroit.
I mean, what McEnany said there is just a lie. Biden's margin of victory outperformed Hillary Clinton's in at least 31 urban counties, and it just so happens Philly was not one of them. But still, month after month, millions infected with the virus of the big lie. And now, according to a Pew Research poll, 80% of Trump voters over 50 incorrectly believe that Trump definitely or probably won the election. 67% of Trump voters with college degrees believe the big lie. 82% of Trump voters without any college education believe the big lie. 2 days before the mob was chanting, "Hang Mike Pence," because he would not overturn the election, this is Mike Pence in Georgia.
I know we all got our doubts about the last election. And I want to assure you, I share the concerns of millions of Americans about voting irregularities. And I promise you, come this Wednesday, we'll have our day in Congress. We'll hear the objections. We'll hear the evidence.
The big lie that on January 6th, the election could be overturned. And then came that day. The MAGA movement and MAGA media were all in.
I have friends who've texted me who are not very political saying, I'm coming to Washington, D.C. today because I can't handle what's happening in my country. I think it's not an understatement to say we're in a constitutional tinderbox right now.
Let's have trial by combat.
If you're going to be the zero and not the hero, we're coming for you and we're going to have a good time doing it.
If Mike Pence does the right thing, we win the election.
And that is how the terrorist attack of January 6th happened. Millions of Americans infected with the virus of disinformation. It was a joint effort by far-right hate groups that the president's been playing footsie with for years and radicalized, infected Trump supporters and MAGA media. Multiple dead bodies later, no contrition, no apologies, no acknowledgement of what they did. Until those who spread the big lie work to correct it, putting out a vaccine of facts and truth, I fear that the U.S. will continue to be in this bad and dangerous place even after the inauguration. And I wish, in my soul, I wish that I saw any evidence that any of these people had a conscience for this to even nag at.